What the hell is that guy doing? I don't think we talked to him last episode. Let's see what he wants. Or is doing, rather. Come here! Look at that poor girl over there. She works so hard taking care of her chickens, even though touching them gives her goosebumps. What a trooper! I would really like to help her. I've just been feeling so charitable these days. Don't you feel the same way, too? Not really. Hey everybody on YouTube, this is Super Nintendo, and welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. In the last episode, we came here to Kakariko Village, got acquainted with everyone here, got two heart pieces, got ourselves another song, and we got ourselves the adult wallet by helping out one of the members of the Skullchilla family. This episode, we're gonna go up to Death Mountain. Ooh. Death Mountain. I don't know why I made that noise. What does this sign say? Death Mountain, no passage without royal decree. The road is closed beyond this point. Can't you read the sign over there? No, I'm 9. Eh? Oh, I see. You're just a kid and you can't read yet. Wah-ha-ha-ha! Jerk. Maybe this'll change your mind. Oh, this is surely Princess Zelda's handwriting. Let's see. Okay. This is Link. He is under my orders to save Hyrule. What kind of funny game has our princess come up with now? Okay, alright. You can go now. Just be careful, Mr. Hero. By the way, Mr. Hero, if you're going to climb Death Mountain, you should equip a proper shield. It's an active volcano, after all. If you go back to Hyrule Castle Town Market, you should check on the bazaar. They sell the shield you'll need there. Tell them I sent you, and they should give you a special discount. If you think you're good to go already, don't worry about it. Now I'd like to ask a favor of you. No, I don't expect you to do it just because of the great tip I just gave you. I'm just asking. Have you been to the Happy Mask Shop that opened in Hyrule Castle Town Market? Everyone's talking about it. Why do you keep yelling at me? My little boy pesters me about a popular mask, but I don't have time to go there. So you should go and get a mask for me next time you are in the market. If you don't feel like it, that's okay, but... Well, I have no choice. This is my job. You know, getting a proper shield probably would be a good idea. Why don't we go do just what he told us? Not the mask thing. He's an ass for making fun of us, so we're not gonna get him a mask. But now that we're in the market, how about we see if we can get ourselves a shield? Welcome! My current hot seller is the Hylian Shield, but it might be too big for you, kid. Let's get it. You heard about us from the guard at Death Mountain Gate? Well, I'll have to give you a good deal then. We got the Hylian Shield. Switch to the equipment subscreen and equip the shield. A 100. I don't know how much we lost, but that guard in Hyrule Castle in, that guard in to Death Mountain, his little tip gives us a random discount. It can be anywhere from, the price can be anywhere from $75 to $40, I believe, or 40 rupees rather. And it's kind of cool, I guess, but there's a better way to get the Hylian Shield. If you go to the... There's a better way to get the Hylian Shield. If I can turn back time. If I could turn back time. I could show you the way. And I can teach you how to get the shield for free. If I could turn back time, I could show you the way. Okay, that's how you get the thing for free. But now that we have the proper shield, let's go in and see if we can't climb Death Mountain. I'm not gonna bother switching my shield just yet, so it's fine. Welcome to Death Mountain Trail. If I could turn back time. I've got to have that song stuck in my head now. God damn it. These things are red Tektites. Lock onto it as it jumps with L targeting, and you can slash at it. They're really not all that, you know, threatening. Also, I just noticed our shield is a flat texture.
They say that a beautiful fairy lives on top of Death Mountain. Don't you want to see her?
I would, but the way looks blocked. So we're going to have to keep that in mind for later. Oh my god! Ah. Ow. Hey, jerk.
I wish I could roll down the mountains like a rock with a bomb flower and BOOM! If I could do that with a bomb flower, I could become a real man.
These guys are the Gorons. They got big, pudgy lips.
If I could turn back time.
Okay, I gotta stop doing that. I didn't mean to do that. That is a big fairy, or a fairy spirit, I guess. Those give us a full heal. I didn't mean to summon that thing. I didn't know the Sun Song could even do that. I thought I needed a different song. Welcome to Goron City.
Oh, I'm so hungry. Everyone feels faint from hunger because of the food shortage in this town. We're in danger of extinction. It's all because we can't enter our quarry, the Dodongo's Cavern. We Gorons live on a diet of rocks. And the most delicious and nutritious rocks are around are found in Dodongo's Cavern. But that seems like ancient history now. We've become such gourmets that we can't stand to eat rocks from anywhere else.
Okay. Let me talk about this. In the... In Aaron Hansen's Sequelitis video talking about A Link to the Past and Ocarina, he complains about this. He complains about the fact that the Dodongo's cavern is blocked off and they're starving because they can't get the rocks they need to survive.
There are more important matters at hand. The Sheikas or the Hylians or whatever, save the Hylians. Gorons don't have rocks to eat. That's why you got a quest. Gorons gotta eat. The fuck are the Gorons? I don't even care. Giving Gorons rocks?
There's rocks everywhere. What is wrong with you? Your whole town is made of rocks and you're starving?
It's explained right here. And to make this even worse, he uses this bit of dialogue in his video when he's complaining about it. So he knows this line exists and he doesn't fucking pay attention to it. But, even more to the point, take this line from Futurama.
Come on, we're starving here.
But you live in a gingerbread house.
Hey, it's food or shelter, not both.
You lazy runt.
Yeah, it's food or shelter, but not both. How fucking stupid are you? Oh my god.
I want to eat the top sirloin rocks from Dodongo's cavern.
I'm sorry, like, Aaron Hansen's stupidity really gets on my nerves.
Hey! It's dangerous for a little kid like you to come out here. You might fall down. If I'm not mistaken, you came out here to eat the red stone. Well, too bad. It's not here. It's in my stomach. What? That's not why you're here. You're looking for a spiritual stone. You must mean that delicious-looking red stone that was once displayed here. I was so hungry that I thought it would be okay if I just gave it one tiny little lick. So I snuck out here, but it's already gone. I think Big Brother took it away. He says that everyone is after that red stone. Big Brother has shut himself in his room saying, I will wait in here for royal family's messenger.
It looks like something used to be set in this stand. Gee, I wonder if it's the thing he just told us about, Navi. So, one thing I would kind of like to bring attention to is this big pot thing. I played this game, like, over 100 times. I am not exaggerating. And I never noticed this thing had a pot lid. What do you say?
Big Brother has shut himself in his room, saying, I will wait in here for the royal family's messenger.
Ah, you already said. Well, maybe he'll be happy to see us.
What the heck? Who are you? When I heard the song of the royal family, I expected their messenger had arrived, but you're just a little kid. Has Darunia, the big boss of the Gorons, really lost so much status to be treated like this by his sworn brother, the king? Now I'm really angry. Get out of my face now. Are you asking why I'm such in a bad mood right now? Ancient creatures infested the Dodongo's cavern. We have a poor harvest of our special crop bomb flowers. Starvation and hunger because of the rock shortage. But this is a Goron problem. We don't need any help from strangers.
You seem kind of angry. Do you say anything else? This is a go-around problem you don't need. Okay. Maybe we should go talk to someone else? Maybe they have an idea of how to calm him down so he doesn't punch us in the face?
I'm so hungry that I can't think of anything but food! Ask Big Brother about complicated things. If he's in a bad mood, he'll probably get mad at you. It can be pretty scary, but I know his secret. He may not look like the type, but Big Brother loves to dance. If he gets in a rhythm, he'll surely... I remember Big Brother used to always listen to that music that comes from the forest. Ah, yes, the good old days. That music makes me feel nostalgic, too. When all the torches on this floor are lit, Goron City is really lively.
Well, maybe we should light some torches, then. You know, the funny thing is, I don't even listen to Cher. I'm pretty sure what I was singing before is pretty much a Cher song. And the only version of that song that I ever heard is from the Stewie Griffin Uncut Story, where it's basically like Meg Griffin doing it. I don't know why, that's the only version of that song I know. And I'm pretty sure it might actually still be Cher doing it. It might just be that they're using the song, but make sure to put away your Deku stick before it burns up.
How was Big Brother? I see. By the way, do you know the music coming from deep inside this tunnel? We all like this music.
Well, there's bombs there, so maybe we should blow things up. Oh, God!
No! Don't blow me up!
Huh. Let's see where this goes.
Hey, over here! Woohoo! Link, good to see you again. Listen to this, hoot-hoot! After going through the Lost Woods, you will come across the Sacred Forest Meadow. This is a sacred place where few people have ever walked. Shh, what's that? I hear a mysterious tune. You should listen for that tune, too. Hoo-hoo-hoo! Do you want to hear what I said again? No. If you are courageous, you will make it through the forest just fine. Just follow your ears and listen to the sound coming from the forest. Hoot hoot! On my first playthrough, going through the Lost Woods actually was very difficult for me because I kept getting lost. I know. But now, I know this area like the back of my hand. Meet the Wolfos. Draw it close to you and watch its movements carefully. Attack it when it drops its guard. Hover! All you have to do is just whack it once with a Deku stick and it dies. This is another thing that Aaron Hansen complains about in his video talking about A Link to the Past. Mad Scrub. If you get close to it, it will hide in the grass. In his video talking about Ocarina of Time and A Link to the Past, he complains about the combat and basically says that every enemy has a period where they just stand around and do fucking nothing, and attacking them during this time is useless. And that isn't true. That really isn't true. Like, yeah, every enemy does have a phase like that, but the thing is, most enemies have a weakness. Most enemies can be beaten pretty simply if you know how to fight them. And
from what I've seen of his Ocarina of Time videos on Game Grumps, because, you know, to be fair, maybe, like, he is just acting stupid for the sake of his videos. No, he really just doesn't pay attention and doesn't even try to experiment. Like, the Deku Nuts, in particular, are really good for stunning enemies. The Deku Sticks do way more damage than your sword as Kid Link, and I don't understand that man. I do not understand anything, like, why he is so fucking retarded. Man, that guy pisses me off. Waiting for you, Link. This is the Sacred Forest Meadow. It's my secret place. I feel this place will be very important to both of us someday. That's what I feel. If you play the ocarina here, you can talk with the spirits in the forest. Would you like to play the ocarina with me? Don't do it. Huh? How boring. Come on, play along. Okay, try to follow along with the melody I will play. Are you ready? Great, great! Please don't forget this song. Do you promise? When you want to hear my voice, play Saria's song. You can talk with me anytime. You learned Saria's song. When you want to hear my voice, play Saria's song. You can talk with me anytime. I wonder what she says if we play it right here. Do you want to talk to Saria? You want to talk to Saria, right? Link? This is Saria. Can you hear me? I don't mind talking to you using the ocarina's magic, but I'd really like to talk to you face to face. Okay, that was funny. But now that we have this song, there is something that I would like to do here in the Lost Woods. There's a couple of things that we can do here. So, how about we hop along? And hop along, and hop along, and hop along. If you roll before you go off a cliff, you actually get quite a lot of airtime compared to your normal ones. Hoo-hoo! Did you learn an ocarina song from Saria? That melody seems to have some mysterious power. There may be other mysterious songs like that you can learn in Hyrule. If you hold the ocarina with C, where a melody is necessary, a musical staff will appear. Huh? I recommend that you play a song you know. I also suggest that you play even a score is not displayed. Just like this. Hoo-hoo-hoot! Hoo-hoo-hoot! Hoo-hoo-hoo-hoot! Do you want to hear what I said again? No. Melodies you have learned will be recorded on the quest status screen. You should memorize those melodies. Don't start talking like Axel. I don't need to get it memorized. But enough about referencing other games. There are other things that we can do. So why don't we go ahead and do them? First things first is this fellow here. This is a Skull Kid. Is this what happens to kids who get lost in the forest? He might be our friend if we do something. You know Saria's song? We should be friends! Here, take this. You got a piece of heart. Now we've collected three. With another piece, our life energy will be powered up. But another thing is if we come down here, not only will we find another gossip stone, but we will find what looks to be a different kind of Deku.
I surrender! To make your quest easier, I can enable you to pick up more Deku sticks, but it'll cost you 40 rupees.
What do you need money for?
Whatever. Let's make a deal. Thank you very much.
We got the ability to pick up more Deku seeds. We can now carry 20 of them. And he also gives us another 10, which is very nice. Deku sticks are very useful, so it is very good to have them. Actually, for the longest time, I didn't even know there were Deku scrubs that allowed you to pick up more items like this. It's kinda cool. Another thing is, there appears to be some kind of target here. I feel the need to shoot it, and I did not do it well.
Cool! You're great! You scored 3 perfect bullseyes! I have to give you a neat present to such a wonderful person. Please take it. It's dangerous to go alone without it.
Boo-doo-doo-doo! We got Deku Seed's bullet bag. It has gotten even bigger. We can now carry 50 bullets. Very nice. If we come over here, there are plenty of rupees hidden away in these bushes. And there's this tree stump with 2, count them, 2 Skull Kids. Follow along with our song on your ocarina. We'll lead you to it. That was quite a nice session. As a token of our friendship, please take this. We get 1 rupee. But if we do it again, these notes are randomly generated, so my notes will be different from yours. I'm gonna laugh if this is Zelda's lullaby. Ah, damn it. Of course, it wouldn't be that simple. That was quite a nice session. As a token of our friendship, please take this. He gave us a blue rupee. And if we play it once more, I'm gonna be impressed if I do this in one go.
That was quite a nice session. As a token of our friendship, please take this. We get another piece of heart. We get... our life energy has been increased. Very, very nice. But there's one more thing we can get here before we head back to the Goron chief, the Great Darunia. If we change it to nighttime, there is something special for us if we come all the way around here. There is a golden Skulltula right here. There we go. Now let's head back to Darunia. I'll see you guys there. Mr. Goron, I'm back, and I got something to cheer you up.
Come on! Heart! What a heartbeat! Whoa! Yeah!
Woohoo!
Hey! What a nice tune. Just like that, my depression is all gone. Something just came over me. I suddenly wanted to dance like crazy. I am Darunia. I'm the big boss of the Gorons. Was there something you wanted to ask me about? What? You wanted the Spiritual Stone of Fire, too? The Spiritual Stone of Fire, also known as the Goron's Ruby, is our race's hidden treasure. But hold on. I'm not going to give it to you that easily. If you want it so badly... why don't you go destroy the monsters inside Dodongo's cavern and prove you're a real man? That way, everyone will be happy again. If you do it, I will give you anything you want, even the Spiritual Stone. I have something for you. I'm not really giving you this in return for anything, but just take it anyway. If you wear this, even a little fellow like you can pick up a bomb flower using A. We got the Goron's bracelet. Now you can pull up bomb flowers. Stand next to one and press A to pull it up. Another thing the game doesn't tell you about is with this you can pick up bushes. I don't really know why you would want to pick up a bush, but you can do it. I think this will do it for this episode. Next time on The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, we head into Dodongo's cavern and see if we can't do something about their little food shortage problem. Alright, see you guys then.
Let it all out. Let it all out. Your heart is made of steel. Come away now from your own doubt. Like a flower of hope that's growing in a field, you will heal. Although the road has changed you and the world has often failed you, you gotta carry on and show them you're strong. You gotta bury what is past and gone. Some days will be worse than others, but you gotta find another way, yeah, yeah. never walk away from who you are. Never forget that your future's waiting up ahead. Seasons change and rearrange, and the sands of time descend.